what I want to talk to you about is some learnings that I have over about my short but 13-year career of working in the digital technology design, however you want to look at it, space of innovation. And this idea of how to create and sustain a culture of innovation. Because the one thing that's interesting about my business, and I'm going to give you just a quick history on it to help you understand where I'm coming from. About 2.5 years ago, Symbility acquired it. For about a decade, we've been working with everyone from Silicon Valley startups to the likes of BitTorrent and StubHub and Facebook and other people far outside of the insurance world to help them do product design, development, innovation, back-end, web products, mobile products, etc. And this idea of this culture of innovation is important because we, even today, about every 6 months, have to reinvent our business. And so the key three things I'm going to talk about today is people, process, and technology. And it sounds a little bit boring, but I find it pretty interesting. If you ever visit our office by St. Lawrence Market here in Toronto, I've got about 100 people from designers, engineers, solutions architects, and we have this sign in our front entrance. Futurism, building a fake future in the hopes that the real future will show up to mate with it. And it's funny, and you know, at first when I read it, I was like, you know, that's not what we're about, but there's parts of that that are true. Is that if you are going to be a company that's going to say, here's our labs group, or here's our team that's going to think about innovation, or we're going to hire a company like Intersect to work with us, there is a lot of unknown in what you're doing. And so the people, the process, and the technology that you give them to support them in this process has to be okay with that unknown. And when I talk about innovation, I like to define it. And one of the things that I've also learned over all the years of working with a lot of these companies inside and outside of insurance in Canada, the US, UK, throughout Europe, Australia, and even Japan, is that innovation is truly about creating new value or capturing value in new ways. Whenever I meet with someone and they're like, we want you to partner with our new innovation team, or can you help us figure out innovation? I always start with working with them to define what innovation is. And it needs to be unique for their company, but it's always shades of essentially this. But the other thing that I underline when I talk to the senior leaders is that it's about this new value that you have to create, but ultimately what it feeds off of, the food that innovation has to have, is momentum and trust. I know now a client of ours, about 2 years ago, they did a one-time hack within their company. They thought, we're going to take a few days off work, people are going to be able to get together on Teams, and we're going to have this hack day, create ideas, present it back, we'll have like our Dragon's Den, you know, group of people going, and they did it as this one-time thing that they thought was going to be incredible. They did press releases that they were doing this.